Hi, and welcome to 3dmotive.com. In this week's tips and tricks video, we're going to briefly cover what trigger volumes are inside of UDK, how they can be used, and walk through a quick example of actually setting one up. So what we've got here in our example map is I've set up a quick matinee of these doors here, just kind of closing, almost slamming shut. And in this example, what we're going to do is just kind of walk through the setting up of a trigger volume to where when you pass through the volume, it's actually going to cause these doors to close before you can get into the elevator there. So let me kind of scrub this back off to the side. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to need to create a brush that we want to represent the size of our volume. So if I just go up here, go to Show, make sure my Builder Brush is on, I can right-click on the Builder Brush. I'm just going to click Build, and let me go over here and right-click on my viewports so I can kind of see where these are. And Builder Brush is where? Okay, it's right over here. It's just a little tough to see there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of drag it to the area where these doors are. Now the doors are these little purple pieces of geometry right here that we have these keys on. And I'm just going to kind of move this into place. I'm going to go maybe back to my perspective view. Turn my shaded back on. And then as we can see, the Builder Brush is way up here at the top. I'm just going to slide this down a bit. And make it big enough so that the player wouldn't be able to kind of sneak maybe behind these boxes or in any other from any other direction if they weren't going, let's say, straight on to get to this door. So I'm just going to move it up and nudge it up against the wall here. Sorry for moving the camera a bit much. And then from here, instead of actually building any type of piece of geometry, what I'm going to do is I'm going to right-click on this Add Volume, and I'm going to click Trigger Volume. And then when I move this, what we'll see is we now have a green box that basically takes up the exact same space of this Builder Brush. I can click Cancel here. And what this does is we can now set this up inside of Kismet to be our trigger volume. So from here, what I'm going to do is I can go back over to Kismet. And I've actually just kind of rearranged some of the existing Kismet for this section, just for this example. But right here, the open left and right vault doors, that's actually the minimatic that I used to kind of edit and just show you a second ago. So what I'm going to do is, with the trigger volume selected, I'm going to go ahead and right-click and say New Event using trigger volume underscore 2 and say Touch. Because we want this to be activated when a player touches it or basically the player touches it. So from the touched state, what I'm going to want it to do is play this matinee. And if I go ahead and minimize this, I'm just going to back up here, and I'm just going to go ahead and right click on the floor and say play from here. Kind of bring this back over. Now what we'll see is when we go up to the door here, it's now going to slam shut in front of us because we use that trigger volume to basically cue the matinee. Now, the nice thing about trigger volumes is I'm not just limited to little individual matinee sequences like this. I can actually use these trigger volumes to fire off maybe effects or particle effects inside of the environment. I could have actually added more to this matinee sequence here where I had maybe sound playing and more effects playing. And as we're going to see here in just a second, if I go up here in this top level and actually go through this wall here, you'll see there's a different part to this level. If I go ahead and do a play from here, what we'll see is we've got this green trigger volume, and what this is actually going to do is, rather than cue some individual, like I said, little matinee sequence, like a door closing, this is actually going to cue up and play a full minimatic where you actually cut away from the player cam. So if I walk through this trigger volume right here, you'll see that you're actually going to be playing a full cinematic. So it's nice that, you know, we have trigger volumes can actually do this. It'll pull you away from gameplay. It can just do a whole slew of things inside the actual game that your player actually kind of fires off just by walking through an invisible space in the level. Okay, well that concludes this little quick tips and tricks lesson. Thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.